Today, I'm going to be showing you how to set up a PiHole DNS server running on Podman on top of Fedora Linux. What's going on, everyone? My name is Talmadge with Big Bro Security, and let's get more secure together. In today's video, we are going to be going over how to install PiHole DNS server on Podman on top of Fedora Linux, as well as the Unbound DNS server that is a recursive DNS server for PiHole to query to further ensure our privacy and security of our DNS requests. Let's get into it. So the first thing we'll do is open up our web browser. I'm using the Arc web browser. It's a pretty new project, but I really like it. Here you can see I'm in my cockpit dashboard. If you are not on Fedora Linux, then this tutorial may or may not apply to you. I would recommend it installing Cockpit. And once you do that, then you'll be able to follow this tutorial a lot easier as it pretty much requires using Fedora Linux. Now, you could SSH in with the terminal and do all this stuff equivalently in the terminal, but it's going to be a lot more difficult than just doing it here, as the Cockpit UI makes it pretty easy. So the first thing we're going to want to do in our terminal is run make directory /podman, make directory /podman/pihole, and make directory /podman/unbound. So these directories are going to store our volumes for PiHole and then our unbound configuration file later in this video. So now we'll make a directory /podman/pihole called /etc/pihole, and then make one called /etc/dns/masq.d. There we go. Now we're done with this. We're going to go ahead and set up PiHole first, and then we're going to come back and finish by setting up Unbound DNS. So let's go over here now to our Podman containers menu, and we'll click create container. Now I'm going to name mine PiHole. They always choose random names for these for some reason. I'm not sure why, but I like having mine named what they are. So for now, that's what we're going to do. You know, maybe there is some merit to random container names, which actually, take that back, there is some merit if you're running clusters of containers and having a whole bunch of them. It's useful just to have them random names. But obviously, I'm just running one right now, so I'm just going to name it what it is, which is PiHole. We're going to search in here in image, search PiHole. And we can see the official Docker PiHole image. We're going to change this to bash, and then we're going to set this to 1 GB of RAM. I'll do on failure. All right, so we're going to be mapping this to our host port. So to do that, we're going to go to 192.168.1.150, and we're going to do port 5353, then 192.168.1.150, again 5353, and this time UDP. And then 192.168.1.150, and we need to do 80. Now I'm going to change this though on my host to 8080. That one remains TCP. Now we're going to want to add a volume, and so to do that, we're going to go to /home/talkelly3/podman/pihole/etc/pihole. And then /home/talkelly3/podman/pihole/etc/dns/mask.d. For the container path, we're going to do /etc/pihole, and I'll just give it a shared label, and then /etc/dns/mask.d. And this one's also going to be shared. Now environment variables, we'll do tz America/Chicago. So we're setting our environment variables like we would in the config file, which if you look over here at their documentation, you can see some of these right here. So time zone is one, web password is another one that we're going to want to set. Web password equals big bro DNS test 123! And this should be all that you really need to create right now. Now we'll run create and run. As you can see here, it's downloading the container, exited, and it's checking health. So we have an error. Look in the logs, you can see permission denied. And if we look in SE Linux, we have some blocks. So what we want to do is go ahead and run this, because we don't want to just disable SE Linux, because that's insecure. Okay, so I ended up going back and disabling SE Linux. As you can see, there's a lot more little errors that keep throwing up. So I'm going to have to go back and fix those after this video is done. But for now, I'm just going to leave it off so that way this tutorial works. I recommend that you go back and slowly work through all these SE Linux errors and file all the exemptions so that eventually you can turn SE Linux back on and it's not going to stop you from doing what you want to be doing. Anyways, for now, we should be able to head on over to http://192.168.1.150:8080/admin. And here we are in our PiHole instance. Successful. Let's go ahead and type in our password. Okay, and after we put in our password, now we are in. So here you can see this little status, all this stuff. I don't know how accurate the temperature is considering it's in a container, but they do store the temperature up there in Celsius. So we can look and see there's a lot of queries. Now, a cool little thing over here that you can do is go to the web interface and change it to Star Trek Picard LCARS theme. Picard's. If you turn off box layout, it looks even better. However, I'm going to go back to the normal theme because we want to just look normal for this tutorial. So the next thing to do now is to go ahead and set up our unbound recursive DNS server so that we can finish properly setting up PiHole and then we'll add it to our router. So first thing we're going to do that is go back into our terminal and cd into /podman-unbound. And I'm using nvim. You can also use nano or vim or vi, whichever floats your boat, but I'm going to do nvim./unbound.conf. Okay, so now we're going to paste in this config file from my website linked up here. I got this from the PiHole documentation for Unbound and then altered it a little bit and added some things that I found along the way that I liked. So basically, to run over this really quick, verbosity set 0, interface 0000, so that's on everything. Port, we're going to change to port 5353, so that way it can still communicate on this host. You'll figure that out in just a second. Do IP4, do UDP, do TCP, do IP6, no. For IP6, nope. Hardened glue, yes. Hardened DNSSEC, which means we're going to be using DNSSEC, yes. Use all caps, nope. We're leaving this at default. Performance settings, we are going to prefetch domains. Number of threads is 1. I set the RCV buffer to 5. It's defaultly set at 1. You can leave it at 1, but 5 megabytes I thought was okay. Access control, basically we're only allowing requests to come in from the 10.192 and 172 subnet. I'm just setting the 172 as well, even though only really the 10 dot because of the containers and the 192 is on my network. If I decide to use Docker, it might, you know, somehow it might be pulling from 172. So I just thought I'd add that in there. Of course, these are private addresses, so it's not going to resolve any of these, like 169.254 or any of the other RFC 1918 addresses listed here. So we're going to go ahead and colon WQ out of this, or you can do control X to save in nano and exit. And now we're going to go over to Podman containers, click create container, and name one unbound. You don't have to name it, but that's what I'm going to do. Go ahead and search in here unbound, and we'll take the Alpine Linux unbound, and we'll set this to bash. And the memory limit is going to be at 512 megabytes because it really doesn't need very much. Restart on failure, maximum retries 5. Add port remapping 192.168.1.150. 5353, TCP. And we'll go ahead and add one for UDP 192.168.1.150. 5353. UDP. Add volume. /home/talkelly3/podman/unbound/unbound.conf/etc/unbound/unbound.conf. This doesn't need to be writable, can be read only. And we'll do shared, create, and run. as you can see here. Looks like this is running. So this isn't working. Right here, you can see it's fixed R3 permissions or systl, bigger net core, m max Linux. So the solution to this is to type sudo systl net.core.rmm_max and then the number that you get from this Podman container, which as you can see is right there. That's how much it wants. So that's what I did. We'll just stop it and then we'll start it again. And okay, it looks like it's a bit better. Now this should be working. So what we'll do is we'll go back to PiHole, go to settings, custom one, and then we'll do 192.168.1.150:5353. We'll uncheck these and then click save. Now to answer maybe a few questions you might have about, well, why am I doing this? You know, what's the point? What am I actually doing? So basically the way PiHole works is it's a DNS server and it has a certain log in this portion over here, add list. There are certain lists that you can add to this that say, let's block things that are in here. So like, for example, you might have example.com in your list. Example.com is going to be blocked. And it does this because your computer will reach out to PiHole and say, hey, who is example.com? Like, what IP address do they have? And then PiHole will say they have 0.0.0.0, which is non-routable, AKA it's blocked. And so your web browser will be like, hey, DNS just didn't respond. Now, when PiHole does actually want to give you something and it's not in the block list, it's not already cached in PiHole from previous use, what it's going to have to do is say, PiHole is going to say, Google, who is example.com? And then they're going to get a lot more information about your full-on DNS request than if you use something like Unbound, which is a recursive DNS provider. And so basically what the Unbound server does is it says, PiHole says, okay, Unbound, who is example.com? And Unbound says, okay, it ends in .com. So it reaches to one server and says, hey, what is the .com? Send me all the servers that run the .com's space. And then it reaches out to the TLD server and it says, okay, .com server, what is the authoritative server for example.com? And then it tells it what it is. And then it goes to the authoritative server for example.com that knows, like, this is the IP address for example.com. It pulls then the IP address and there your DNS request is completed. So it goes through the whole list of everything. And that just makes it a whole lot better than and more anonymized and private than if you were going to do, say, Google, for example, or even Quad9 or Cloudflare. Here I am at my TP-Link router. And here we go. Now I'm logged in. So the thing that I will want to do is go over to advanced, go to DHCP server. So that hands out everything. And we're going to want to change our primary DNS to 192.168.1.150. And we'll click save. So as all these different devices get new DHCP leases, they will get the new IP address. So now if you want to import some block lists into PiHole, a good place to look is the block list projects. And here you can basically look at list of different block lists. You can get links to these and then you can paste them in. So for example, if you want to block everything related to malware that this list has, at least, then we can do this link, copy it out of here, go over here, click add list, malware, add, and it should be enabled. So you can do the same thing with tons of other types of different add lists if you want. You can see there's already 6 queries that have been blocked. So that's pretty neat. All of these are for mask.icloud.com. So this is going to be where iCloud is trying to mask my browsing and IP address, etc. So I could bypass that if I need to, but obviously right now, you know, everything works fine. I don't really need to. I probably will at some point though, go through and look and see, okay, these are legitimate. I'm going to allow these and other things I'm not, but it's pretty cool. You know, you never really notice, oh, iCloud's using a masking service, unless you had something like this where you're able to review everything. And you can see here all your top clients show up, so all the top IP addresses, etc. There's a lot of really cool features. You can do groups and, you know, enable different groups for different things in here. There's a query log, so you can see exactly what it is querying and who is querying that, which will give you a lot of information about different types of devices, etc. You can see add specific domains to allow or disallow. And of course, this dashboard is just pretty sweet to sit here and look at as all these bars fill up. I personally, again, prefer doing the Star Trek Picard LCARS theme. I think it looks super cool on this dashboard and it just looks super, super nice. So anyways, that's what I'm gonna do. All right, everyone, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found some useful tips or knowledge out of this video. If you did, please feel free to drop a like. Comment down below if you have any insights into how to work better with the SE Linux system especially, because I'm very keen to know how to do that. I couldn't really figure it out from the bit of Googling that I did, although I'm going to keep adding in exceptions and seeing if I can get this thing to run smoothly with SE Linux enabled. Subscribe to the channel if you aren't already and are looking forward to future videos. I know I went on a really, really long hiatus with producing probably a total of under 10 videos in the past like 2 years, but that is all about to change for sure. I'm getting into cybersecurity a lot more than I have in probably the past 2 years right now. And I'm super excited for all the different things I'm learning and excited to teach you guys everything new that I'm learning that I possibly can teach you. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm Talmadge from Big Bro Security, signing out.